This is a recording of my nonprofit Cloud for Programs journey. And at this stage, we're creating and managing schedules. And just to give you the full picture, this is the trail. The first step was about building out programs and benefits for the attendance and benefit tracking. The first step was adding program participants. And now we're adding schedules. These are benefit schedules for services. Again, a bit of jargon. Looking back at this, again, this is a schema that I built. We initially built a program which had benefits needed to have benefit types and units of measure. And then we were able to add participants in a program through program enrollments. And now our focus is on benefits schedule and especially for benefits session. This information was pulled from the case management data model. And what we're looking at is program and benefits, and especially benefit schedules and benefit sessions. So we're going to build three types of sessions. The first is a benefit, a one-time benefit, then a regular recurring, and then we're going to add a session to the one-time benefit session. So to schedule a one-time benefit session, we're going to create this schedule for just one session. Now the instructions are to select the introduction, that should have been bolded, interesting, introduction to healthy cooking class benefit from a global search. Rather than a global search, let's be a little smarter. Since I'm adding classes on nutrition, I can start with the programs and go through this way. And the program says nutrition, and I can go to my related list, drop down to benefits. So we're defining the intro to healthy cooking benefit and click new benefit schedule. And click new benefit schedule. And they ask us to add a name. This benefit quantity is going to be relevant when we talk about outcomes, but for now just we're entering one. We can have a max participant count. So you can see that most of these fields are required, but we need a session date, which they're saying tomorrow, do that. And a start time, which they're suggesting is 7:30 p.m. It's the only unfortunate part is you have to actually drag to get there. I haven't found a workaround for that. So we know it's a 1 hour session, so the session end time should automatically end at 8, but we actually have to enter that or select it. And then our session frequency is weekly. Now if we said it was monthly, it would actually just follow on the days, but we're gonna do it weekly, so we actually have to select a day of the week, and we happen to know that tomorrow is a Thursday. And we're gonna say the session ends after, because we're gonna just give it one session. And then we can click next. That also tests to see whether or not there's anything missing. And it does give us the one showing up at 7:30. Now note that this time that was scheduled was based on whoever entered it. So make sure that the user has the correct time zone scheduled, otherwise the timing won't work. Just five sessions, but for now we're fine. One, so we can click save. And we're here, we've just created a session for the intro to healthy cooking. So we're going to look at related, and we see that we have a benefit assignment, but we don't have nothing else. Looking at the instructions, what it says is you can find it by searching in global search again. So West Side Kitchen Intro Class. So we're looking for a benefit schedule, and I'm using here, this is a trial org navigation that I basically built that is just all the different objects so we can navigate directly to them. And so we see that we have one scheduled, and this is in the benefit schedules. And then what I went ahead and did was to make this a favorite. So you can see the all benefits schedule is a favorite because we're gonna come back to that regularly. So mark that if you want to. So the next step is scheduling a regularly recurring benefits session. So again, we've got, this time we're building it after 12. And again, we can navigate there by clicking on nutrition. And looking at our benefits, which are, again, services. We're working with the intermediate health cooking class, so we click on that. So we're going to go with a new benefit schedule. Remember, for this example, the benefit quantity is based on hours, but that could differ based on the benefit. So I've entered this information, and now I can click Next. But just testing it, I put the session date as 7:30 a.m. and not p.m., and let's see what it tells us. It tells us we need a day of the week. Okay, Thursday, that's fine. So I'm going to say Next. Oh, it says okay. It needs to be greater than the start time. So that's good. So there's a little bit of logic there checking for us. So we're going to say 7:30, and we're going to click Next. This time we're going to get a bunch more, and only the first five, or we did 12. So we're going to say save, because they seem to be building on Thursdays at 6 p.m. And so now we're here at the benefit, again, looking at the related list of all of the schedules associated with them. We're not benefit sessions, there's nothing scheduled. So we actually have to say, all right, so how do we get there? Let's just go on ahead out to our favorites, and let's bring it up this way. And now we can find the intermediate health cooking class that we built. We're seeing a default time starts. And we are seeing benefit sessions. And we click view all and we get all 12. So now we can move to the third step, which is adding a benefit session to an existing schedule. So we're going to use the one that we did before. And so what it's saying is go out and find it using global search. All right, not the way we're going to do it. So looking at our benefits schedules, all benefits schedules, and I also added a program field in here too. So we could actually sort by that if there were more than one program, just as a way to be able to filter this. So we're selecting the intro class. And looking at the benefit schedule for the West Side Kitchen intro class, now we can go to related, because we're going to have a benefit session. Now we can click new here, but a little trick I found is that if we open this as a new tab, I go out to it, what I can do is just to copy this, because you'll see the instructions are a little wonky. What it says is click new, and then gives you as many the same fields. You have to specify this. So what it says is to enter the date followed by this text. And then you put in a start date and an end date, and you click scheduled. So what we did was to copy this from the existing session, click new. Now we can click this, and we can say we're going to go to a week. Actually, the easy thing to do, right? We can go here. We can say, let's just schedule it. So when are we scheduling this for? We're scheduling it for the 18th. So we say, all right, so now I can go out here and I can edit this one to the 18th. And we have to look at times. We're going to go at 7:30 p.m. to 8:30, because this is that 1 hour session. And the end date is going to be the same. And it's a 1 hour session, so we're going to go out to 8:30. And we're marking the status as scheduled, because it hasn't yet been completed. And so we're clicking save. And now we have a second one scheduled. So at this stage, we have a program and we have a benefit, but we don't have participants in it. So how do we actually build it out so that it can work that way? So if we look at a session, let me just go in on one, and we look at related, we don't have any benefits. Nobody connected to this, but that's the next video. And just again, quick recap. Benefit sessions are master to benefit schedule, benefit schedule to benefit to program. So that's the path. And then we also added participants at a program level. And next we're going to be talking about these benefit assignment, benefit disbursements, which is really the next level jargon that's the most important actually.